Friends, this is Bright here. In this video, I'm going to illustrate how we can change the background color by using radio buttons. And this is the version of my Android Studio 4.01. I'm starting a new project, selecting the MD activity. So let us say that the project name is demo, and here I am using the minimum SDK as 23, then finish. I am taking the main XML, activity main.xml. So here we can see the default layout is constraint layout. I am replacing it with linear layout. This is only for simplicity. So when we are using the linear layout, we can mention whether the orientation is horizontal or vertical. So in this project, I am going with vertical orientation. So I'm removing the default text view. Now, when we are keeping the radio button, we should be little careful because we have to group the buttons. There will be multiple groups of radio button. Then from one group, only one radio button can be activated or it can be checked at a time. So I'm going to create a radio group, then layout width, I'm opting wrap content. So let us go with again layout height, wrap content, then close it. We can see automatically the closing tag is coming. And within the radio group, we can create n number of radio buttons. For that, radio button. And again, layout width, we can mention wrap content, height wrap content, then close it. Now, don't forget to give some text for the radio button. For example, Android colon text, I am going to mention that blue. Since we are going to change the background color by selecting a particular radio button, so this radio button is going to change the background color into blue color. That is the purpose. And I am going to put ID also. For that, just type ID. You can see that automatically that option is coming up. Then select. We can give some name. Let us say that blue ID, a simple ID name. Similarly, create another radio button. Let us say that layout width is wrap content, height is wrap content. Then I am just putting the backslash. Automatically it will be closed. And from here, press enter. Here I am going to mention that text. Let us say that this is for red color. Then ID. Let us say that it is red ID. Now I am going to put one more radio button. And here also, I am going to select the width is wrap content, height is wrap content, close it. And here I am going to say that text, this is for yellow color. Then keep an ID for that. Let us say that yellow ID. And we can see the design part. We can see blue, red, yellow. So I'm taking the code. So it is very easy to understand. In this linear layout, we have only one group, and within this group, we have three radio buttons. Now, we have to change the background color when we select any one of these radio buttons. So for that, we have to take the linear layout object. To find the linear layout component, I am going to include the ID for linear layout also. For that, put ID. Let us say that linear ID. Now I am taking main activity.java. So I am declaring variables for all the radio buttons. So radio button. Let us say for one button, I am naming it as blue, and another button red, third one yellow. So three variables I declared. Then another one for linear layout. Press control space. Automatically it will suggest few names. Either you can go with the any of these names, or you can type any other name. So I am taking linear layout. Now find all the components for radio buttons. Let us say for blue, find v by id r dot id dot blue id. Then next, for the red button, find v by id r dot id dot red id. Then next, yellow button, find v by id r dot id dot yellow id. And next, we are going to find the linear layout. For that, linear layout equal find v by id r dot id dot linear id. Now when we click the blue button, the background color should be changed into blue. For that, we have to do event handling. To do event handling for blue button click, we have to register the radio button for blue with event listener. So the next step is register blue radio button with event listener. For that, take the blue button instance that dot set on checked change listener. This is the method we have to use it for registration purpose. Set on checked change listener. Now type new, give a space, then press control space bar. Automatically an option comes. You can see that compound button dot on checked change listener. Just select it, and you can see that automatically the code is generated. So whenever the blue button is checked or unchecked, this method will be automatically called. So when it is checked, the boolean b value contains true, and when we select another button, for example red, the blue will be unchecked. Again this method will be called. At that time b contains false, and here you can see a variable of type compound button, and this compound button contains the reference of the blue button, whether it is checked or unchecked. Which button has generated the event? Its reference is available with this reference variable compound button. Change the background color to blue if blue button is checked. For that, we can use this boolean b variable. We can use like this, if b. So when it is checked, b contains true. When it is unchecked, b contains false. So when it is checked, only then we have to change the background color. For that, use the linear layout instance dot set background color, and we have a class called color in the package android.graphics. Just select it dot, and we can say that it is blue. That's all. Similarly, we have to do for red and yellow. Register red button with event listener. For that, red button dot set on checked change listener. Now again the same steps, new space, control space, enter. And here change the background color to red if red button is checked. For that, we can use if b, if it is checked. So if true, linear layout dot set background color, color dot red. Similarly for yellow button, register yellow radio button with event listener. Yellow dot set on checked change listener, new space, control space. You can see that automatically that option is coming, coding assistance. And here change the background color to yellow if yellow button is clicked. If again, if it is checked means true, linear layout dot set background color, color dot yellow. Now let us see the status. So I'm going to launch it. I'm going to select blue. You can see that the background color is changed. I'm going to select the next one, that is red. It is changed. Yellow, you can see that. Now when you click blue, the fonts are not so visible. So at that time, if it is white, it will be better. So we are going to add few more coding. So when you click blue, how we can change the font of radio button to white? Red, okay, it is readable. Yellow also it is readable. Only for blue we are going to change it. So take the blue here. After changing the background color, or even before that also we can put it, but within the if condition. Change the text color of radio button, radio buttons red, blue and yellow, all the radio buttons to white. So first I am going to take red, red dot. There is a predefined method called set text color. Take it, then color dot white. Then we are going to change the text color for blue button also. In any order we can put it. Set text color, color dot white, then yellow dot, set text color, color dot white. Now let us see that. I am selecting blue. You can see that now the remaining radio buttons text colors are visible. For red, now it is white, because previously we selected blue, at that time all the fonts are changed. Now when I click yellow also the same problem. So what we have to do is, when you click red, there again we can have our customized code. At that time what should be the font color? So for the red, change the text color of all radio buttons. For that, red dot, set text color, color dot, let us say that we go with black. The same color we can set for the remaining radio buttons. Blue dot, set text color, color dot, black. Then yellow dot, set text color, color dot, black. Now the same set of code I am going to copy and put it for yellow also. Now let us see the status. So I am going to select blue. You can see that everything is white now. All the fonts are in white. Background is blue color. Now red, yes, it is working perfectly. For yellow, yes, it is working perfectly. Hope that all of you understood. Thank you for watching this video.